In this project, I'm going to use Stream Writer and Stream Reader to write data and read it from a file. And then I'm going to do the same thing using the Gzip String class to compress the data. And we'll compare the file sizes. So we know we're going to need the system.io namespace because that's required by Stream Writer and Stream Reader. First, I will create a Stream Writer instance and specify the file name. We'll call it data.bin. Now, writing to this file is really easy. We just need to call streamwriter.write. I'm going to make the file fairly big, so I'm going to use a for loop to write hello world 10,000 times to it. Notice that streamwriter.write can take a variety of different types. I'm just writing a string to it, but you could also write integers or Boolean values or character arrays. So we open it up. Now we need to close it at the end. The file has been created at this point. We just need to create a stream reader to read it in. There goes C# habits. So creating the stream reader is done exactly the same way as the stream writer was. We just specify the file name. Now I'm going to display the entire file to the console by calling streamreader.read2end. In practice, you wouldn't generally read the entire file this way. You'd probably write some binary data to it and then read it back selectively as you would with a binary file. So one last thing I want to do, just for fun, is to check the file size so we can see how effective the compression was after we're done. So I'll do this by creating a file info instance and specifying the same file name. Now I will write to the console. The size of the file. Length is just an integer that is the size of the file in bytes. Oh, one more thing, we will do a console.read key to pause the console at the end. I'll fix my typo here. So I'll run it now. Yep, it wrote it quickly and read in a whole lot of hello worlds. So the total size of the file ends up being 139k, about 140k. So now I'm going to go back and update this to use the Gzip String class instead of using StreamWriter to write directly to the file. So what we need to do is to create an instance of Gzip String. I need to import the system.io.compression namespace to get Gzip String. I need to, as the first parameter, provide a stream. One easy way to do that is to call file.create. I'll just specify the same file name. And as a second parameter, I need to specify either compression mode.compress or decompress. I'm writing to the file, so I want to compress it to make it smaller. When I read it, I will specify decompress. Now when I create the stream writer, this is an overloaded constructor. So instead of specifying the file name, I will specify my instance of Gzip String. And then we'll use the Gzip String, which ultimately ends up writing the same file, but it goes through that extra compression layer provided by the Gzip String class. I don't need to change the writing at all. I just need to close the Gzip String instance. So when I go to read it, I'm going to do basically the same thing. In fact, I'll just copy that. I will change the name to gzin, and instead of calling file.create, I will call file.openread. File name, of course, is the same. And as I mentioned earlier, instead of compressing it, I'm going to decompress it. Once again, that code does not need to change. I just need to close my instance of Gzip String. Oh, I almost forgot to replace the stream reader constructor to use my new instance of Gzip. So this is ready to run. Once again, a lot of hello worlds, and this time the file size is 1.7k about. So we're down to about 1% of the original file size. In this case, the compression was extremely effective. Not really a real-world scenario, because in the real world you won't simply be repeating the same phrase over and over again, which would make the compression very effective. In the real world, it would be a variety of different data. If you are using text, you will see a high level of compression, probably that 99% compression, maybe 90% compression. If it were a binary file, you might see 30 to 60% compression. If you were compressing like a JPEG or an MP3, which are already compressed, you wouldn't see any compression. In fact, the compression might actually make the file size a little bit bigger.